Jill Biden is the first lady, so we get that she's going to have the back of Joe Biden, but she's doing it in a way that I don't know if it's really getting across the message that she thinks it is. So she says the president had so many hopes when he got into office, but the problems of the moment came first. So we want to give you some more details there. She says the president had so many hopes and plans for things he wanted to do, but every time he turned around, he had to address the problems of the moment. This was during a fundraising event in Nantucket. Said he's just had so many things thrown his way. Who would have ever thought about what happened with the Supreme Court overturning Roe v. Wade? Well, maybe we saw it coming, but we still didn't believe it. The gun violence of this country is absolutely appalling. We didn't see the war in Ukraine coming. Now, we have more comments of hers to get to, but I'm gonna take issue with a little bit of her strategy or her view, her narrative here. First of all, most of the things you just cited happened like a year into his presidency. Where are the excuses for the first 12 months, Jill Biden? And it is, we have to admit an admission that when we say as progressives that he hasn't gotten much done, and the head in the sand centrist will be like, how could you say that? Mm-hmm. He's done so much. Well, on our side is Jill Biden, because she's saying he had a lot of hopes, but what are you gonna do? Circumstances intervened. She's being clear. He didn't do nearly as much as he might have planned. It's kind of a rose tinted glasses view of his motivations to begin with, Francesca, but she seems to be on her side that he could have done a lot more.
I guess that, yeah, but I'm also like, I really, and Vice President Kamala Harris made a similar point after the Dobbs decision, which was like, you know, it's different when it actually happens. We sort of felt like it could have, but it just feels a little different. Like, oh yeah, you think it feels a little different? You're in power. What have you been doing about this? We saw this coming. Why do you think there was a massive outpouring the day, the week after Trump was elected, called the Women's March, one of the biggest, if not the biggest mass demonstration in American history? It was because we all saw that our rights could be on the chopping block. And we all saw these decisions coming down the pike. And so to be honest with you, like, of course, they're never gonna talk about Republicans, because it's just, you know, they talk about like the things being rolled back as if it's just a change in the weather. I wonder who's doing this. Gee, yeah. No, it's the hand of God that's just sort of rolling all these rights back. No, you know who it is. It's Republicans. You've known their plan. You've known their plan inside and outside the courts. They've had dark money funneling into all of these Supreme Court justice nominations, including other federal judgeships. Come on, wake up. So when we get told that we're freaking out unnecessarily, or that they've got it, or let the adults of the room handle it, because we know how to RNC whisper, like we know how to Mitch McConnell whisper. No, you don't. You're asleep at the wheel. You have no idea. And look, you say now you're blindsided. Give me a break.
Yeah. Do you want to be furious?
Yes, I know. Listen, I know what's coming. I know it gets worse. I know.
Listen to this next graphic. Jill Biden says she told her own family members they should think about doing more than protesting. Quote, so many young girls, my own grandchildren included, went up to the Supreme Court and marched. I say, okay, good for you, but what are you gonna do next? You feel good about yourself because you voiced your opinion, but what are you gonna do next? What is your plan? And I don't have enough FUs to give to Jill Biden from that. Your husband is the president of the United States, and you're going to your 10-year-old grandchildren saying, what's your plan, Sally? What was his plan? The rights were stripped away on his watch, and that's just one issue. We could go through a bunch. You're taking issue with little Emma? Mm-hmm. You think Emma's the problem? Oh yeah, well, how are you gonna reform the Supreme Court? Talk to Joe, he's technically in charge.
She's so uppity, you know? She's just all into her TikTok or whatever, get a job. Like, what are we, this is a girl who is the same age, again, as the young girl who was raped in Ohio and had to go seek an abortion in Indiana. Or you gonna, as she comes back to Ohio, be like, well, what's your plan to fix it, young lady? Yeah. Like, I'm sorry. I mean, if there's no better like signifier than the adults have left the building. Yeah. Like, absolutely. Like, cause I bet that granddaughter will be like, are you for real? Like, could I be in charge? Cause I'm pretty sure I could do this better than either of you guys. Pop, pop.
Exactly. Exactly. So the pop, pop. Or by the way, I have no idea how old their grandchildren are, but as who said it? It just so flames on the side of my face, flames. Blue Lizard Guts is totally right. How dare you, Jill Biden? Stop talking to Wee Sally and go talk to Kyrsten Sinema, okay? If you wanna talk to someone who's really concerned about being cute all the time, but that might have some influence over the process, I'd start with Sinema and not with Sally, okay? Sally can't even vote. And even if she could, that's not the solution because we already did that. We gave you power. You got the House, you got the Senate, you got the White House. What are you doing with it? And I get that she's not the president, but arguably she can ring him up on the phone and talk to him about his lack of plan.
It's amazing. You know, you could throw the same thing back at her. That's so cute. Wow, so you won the presidency. You must feel really good about yourself. Yay. Mm-hmm. But what are you going to do next, Jill? What are you gonna do with all this power? What's your plan, Jill and Joe?
Yeah.
Incredible. It just absolutely incredible. You know what my plan is, man? Lighting your home on fire. Like, she should just be like, I'm occupying the White House, Mima, right now. Yeah. Just like you hear a click and she's just like chained herself to her grandma. This is what I'm doing.
Yeah, that's right. Plan would be pick up a power drill and tell me which port is Joe Manson's yacht docked in tonight?
Yeah, yeah. You thought 20 bucks every Christmas was gonna shut me up? Nuh-uh. Nuh-uh, Mima.
God, these people. His approval is. I know there are many naysayers who say we'll get slammed in the midterms. Okay, the Republicans are working hard. They stick together for good or evil. So we just have to work harder. First of all, not for good or evil. How the hell do you not know which of those two they've chosen? They've been very clear about it. And so we have to work harder. Stop saying we when you mean y'all, okay? We need to work harder means that you also need to do something. You just mean y'all should vote, okay? If that's what you mean, say that, okay? You can be clear about it.
Just such big one-term energy. Ooh, most one-term energy. You think Trump had one-term energy? I mean, he either had like one-term or forever energy. Just this is just the most one-term president energy.
Yeah, and by the way, like generally, attacks against the first lady, I'm not down for dumb, shallow, stupid, nothing to do. I apologize. That has nothing to do with anything. Mark that. This is her directly spitting in the face of all the voters and mirroring the commentary of all of the quote unquote moderates, by the way. This is not her being a wild card. She is advancing the narrative they would love you to believe going into the presidency. For more political news breakdowns, interviews, stories of activism, and me trying my hardest to care about the occasional big celebrity news story, subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/thedamagereport. And you can ring the bell wherever it is so you don't miss anything.